Mayo Clinic Arizona recently performed what is called a Whipple robotic surgery for pancreatic cancer. It's Mayo's first robotic surgery of this kind, and it promises to improve outcomes for a particularly difficult cancer to treat. Joining us now is Dr. Zhi Fong. He's surgical oncologist at Mayo Clinic. There he is, Mayo Clinic. Good to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me, Ted.
Yeah. Robotic Whipple surgery for pancreatic cancer. What in the world are we talking about here?
So it's a complex operation that we historically have done in an open fashion for pancreatic cancer. What it entails is that we take the head of the pancreas out along with a bit of the stomach and the duodenum, which is your small intestine, and the common bile duct, which is a pipe that connects your liver to your small intestines as well. We do it for pancreas cancer at the head of the pancreas, and it's complex operation that we can now do robotically.
I was going to say, it's a complex operation that obviously a robot could help in what, tight spaces and corners and these sorts of things?
It's mainly that it allows us to perform delicate aspects of the procedure in a minimally invasive fashion. So historically, we do it through an open incision, and usually the recovery is slightly more prolonged and there's more pain associated with it. But with our new technology, with a robotic platform, we are able to do this through smaller incisions and with increase and higher precision when we're actually performing the reconstruction of the operation.
Interesting. I read as well, gallbladder, bile duct. I mean, you mentioned other things here. A lot of stuff comes out, huh?
Lots of stuff comes out, and it's mainly because the pancreas head is in a very inconvenient location where a lot of other organs share the same blood supply. So when you have a cancer in the head of the pancreas, it usually involves removal of all the organs that we just talked about.
Is this for cancer that hasn't metastasized, or if it metastasized, can you still do this?
Mainly it's for cancer that has not metastasized, and once it's metastasized, we can no longer do it. Mm. So only about 20-30% of patients actually qualify for it, because that's how many, the proportion of patients that present with resectable disease, essentially.
I was going to say, pancreatic cancer, it's just such a difficult, is that the reason that it metastasizes when you're not aware anything's going on?
It's a difficult cancer that we struggle with, and mainly because we haven't found a good surveillance program or method or strategy to detect the pancreas cancer early. So only about 20% of patients present with cancer that has not metastasized or spread, and those patients would be candidates for a Whipple procedure.
Can the procedure be used with other disorders involving the pancreas or any other organ?
Yes. So typically any indication for a Whipple operation would be a good indication for a robotic Whipple procedure. Sometimes it's pancreatitis. Sometimes it could be cysts that's pre-malignant that's on its way to become cancer. If we so happen to detect that early, and usually it's in circumstance where it's incidental, we would be able to perform it robotically.
And this was the first time that this particular robotic surgery, this Whipple, was done at Mayo Clinic in Arizona here, true?
Yes, it's our first robotic Whipple operation at Mayo Clinic Arizona, and we performed our first one in October. And we've since done about 8 more, and most of our patients are doing well so far.
Like I was going to say, the results so far pretty good?
It has been great. Most of our patients are doing well. Two of our patients went home 3 days after the operation. They have quick recovery, and part of it is selecting the right patient for the right operation.
I was going to say, and the robotic aspect, as we're seeing here, you need some special training for that, don't you?
Yes, and I'm blessed that I did my training at Mass General Hospital and Brigham and Women's Hospital in Boston, where we do the robotic Whipple operation. And I think part of being in the next generation of surgeons that has come out of training is that we're all trained in robotic approaches. And I think the uptick of robotic Whipple operation throughout the country has been increasing.
The uptick of just robotic operations in general, what are you seeing out there, and how important is that in the treatment? And we'll stick to cancer right now, because you're an oncologist here, and this is the serious stuff. I mean, how important?
I think it's really important, because especially for the Whipple operation that we do, it's historically associated with a perception that it's a big operation, and sometimes patients have the hesitancy to pursue treatment because they think it's a big disfiguring operation. But by doing this robotically, we hope to change that perception, where even a big complex operation doesn't necessarily require a big long incision, where we can still do it through delicate small holes, and the recovery can be quick and well as well.
That minimum invasion, I mean, that's a big deal, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, in terms of recovery, that's a big deal as well. You touched on this earlier, but I mean, I would think recovery would be a lot quicker.
It is a lot quicker, and we feel like the recovery is quicker, your length of stay in the hospital is shorter, the pain is much more well controlled as well. And for patients who are living longer now that we have better therapies for pancreatic cancer, the wound complication rates and the hernia rates are lower with smaller incisions with the robotic approach.
I was going to ask about risks. Are the risks different with the Whipple surgery? Are they different with the robotic Whipple surgery than traditional pancreatic surgery?
So the main complication profile is the same. It doesn't change the operation and how major it is, but the long-term wound complication rates are lower. And we have not studied this in depth yet because we haven't done as many and experience is still quite premature, but we believe that the hernia rates that comes with small incisions are lower than if you had a larger incision.
So hernia rates are something you watch? I'd never heard that. Is that something you watch out for, huh?
Mainly because we've been doing the operation increasingly for non-cancer indications, which means people who get the Whipple operations are actually living longer. So it's only an issue, you know, when patients live longer. And when you do a bigger incision, the risk of hernias are typically higher if you had an open Whipple than if you had a robotic Whipple where the incisions are smaller.
So when you talk to patients about this option, and obviously these are patients that have difficult decisions to make and they need all the help they can get to make that decision, what do you tell them?
What I tell them is that it's the same operation in the sense where the complication and mortality risks are the same, but the recovery seems to be quicker. There's less pain associated with the operation. There is a shorter length of hospital stay. You get back on your feet quicker, you get back to your daily routines quicker, and your long-term wound complication and hernia rates are lower as well with the robotic approach.
Yeah, it's a lot of positives there. Dr. Zhi Fong, again, Mayo Clinic, Arizona. My goodness, congratulations on this and continued success, because it's great to have Mayo Clinic out here doing this kind of work. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me.